Now let's look at assess the risk of material misstatement and design further audit procedures. When we assess the risk of material misstatement, we need to know the classification of material misstatement. In performing risk assessment, it is important for the auditors to recognize that risk of material misstatement occur at both the financial statement level and the relevant assertion level for account balances, transaction glasses, and disclosures. There are two levels of risk may affect the audit in different ways. For the financial statement level risk, that means the risk at the financial statement level are those that relate to the overall financial statements and potentially affect many individual assertions. For example, risks related to an ineffective control environment, a lack of sufficient capital to continue operations, a declining industry. Our overall response to financial statement level risk by the auditor is shown in the following. The first one, assigning the audit to more experienced staff or individual with specialized skills. Two, providing more supervision for the audit staff and emphasizing the need for them to maintain professional skepticism. Number three, incorporating additional elements of unpredictable in the selection of further audit procedure to be performed. And four, increasing the overall scope of audit procedures. For the relevant assertion level risk, this risk relates to one or a few relevant assertions that relate to one or more accounts or disclosures. For example, a risk related to inaccurate counting of inventory at year-end affects the valuation of inventory and the accuracy of cost of goods sold. The response to relevant assertion level risk by the auditor is to implement further audit procedures, including test of control and substantive procedures. Test of control provide auditors with evidence as to whether prescribed controls are in use and operating effectively. The results of these tests assist the auditors in evaluating the likelihood that material misstatements have occurred. Substantive procedures, on the other hand, are designed to detect material misstatements. If they exist in the financial statements, the amount of substantive procedure done by the auditors is greatly influenced by their assessment of likelihood that material misstatement exists. Usually, if auditors have understanding of the client and find that the client has a good internal control at the beginning, they will implement test of control to examine whether the good internal control is operated effectively. If the results of the test of control show that the internal control is very good, that means under this internal control, there are few material misstatements, so the auditors can reduce the scope of substantive procedures. Otherwise, the auditor needs to increase the scope of substantive procedures. If auditors have understanding of the clients and find that the client has a weak internal control at the beginning, they do not need to implement test of control and they must increase the scope of substantive procedures. Now let's look at the fraud risk. When performing risk assessment, the auditor should be alert for significant risk that requires special audit attention. For this risk, the auditor should carefully consider internal controls not relied on controls tested in prior period, and not rely solely on analytic procedure to obtain evidence about the related financial statement assertions. Auditors also need to consider the risk from fraud. There are usually two types, of fraud risks. They are fraudulent financial reporting, we also call them management fraud, and misappropriation of assets, we also call them defalcations. When the auditors find the fraud risk exists, they should implement the following procedures. Discussion among engagement team, inquiries of management and other personnel, doing risk assessment analytic procedures to aid in planning the audit, considering fraud risk factors such as incentive, opportunity, attitude or ability to rationalization. Then, the auditors will respond to the fraud risk. The overall response include adjust professional skepticism and audit evidence, adjust personnel assigned and supervision, adjust scrutiny given to accounting principles, predictability of auditing procedures, and next one is alterations in the audit procedures, so we can get more reliable evidence, and the shifting timing to year end, also increasing the extent of the audit, and the response to the possibility of management override include examining journal entries, review accounting estimates for biases, evaluating the business rationale for significant unusual transactions. After that, the auditor should communicate the evaluation results of audit test and discovery of fraud to the appropriate level of management, or if fraud involves senior management or material misstatement, the auditor should communicate to the audit committee. So, in this chapter, we introduce three items in this chapter. The first one is how to plan the audit. Usually, the auditors need to accept the client and sign the engagement letter with client, and draft the audit strategy and audit plan. Second, the auditor needs to obtain understanding of client. They need to perform risk assessment procedures and decide the preliminary materiality level. Third, auditors will assess risk of material misstatements and pay attention to fraud risks. Now let's move to the professional terms. Audit process, 审计过程。Accepting new client, 接受新客户。Fraud risk, 舞弊风险。Predecessor auditor, 前任审计师。Successor auditor, 后任审计师。Overall audit strategy, 审计策略。Audit plan, 审计计划。Materiality, 重要性。Significant risk, 特殊风险。Financial statement level risks, 报表层次风险。Relevant assertion level risk, 认定层次风险。Fraudulent financial reporting, 财务报告舞弊。Management fraud, 管理层舞弊。Misappropriation of assets, 侵占资产。Incentives, 动机。Opportunity, 机会。Attitude or ability to rationalize, 合理化的态度或能力。